completion of this lecture, you can calculate the sag and tension for your overhead transmission line. So with the equal or unequal towers, right? For calculating the sag, you have to remember some of the formulas. So these are the formulas which you need to remember. So when the supports are at equal levels, so then sag at any point P will be given by the expression y is equal to wx square by 2t. So now if you want to calculate the sag from the support at support A or support B, so then sag is s is equal to wl square by 8t for when supports are at equal levels. Okay, when the supports are not at equal levels, so then you will be having two sags, s1 and s2. So those two sags will be calculated by using the formulas. S1 is equal to wx1 square by 2t and s2 is wx2 square by 2t. What is x1, x2 here? X1 is the distance from support A to center of the conductor O, right? In similar way, x2 is the distance from support B to center of the conductor, which is O. Right here, x1, x2, you can calculate by using the formulas, these two. So which are x1 is equal to L by 2 minus TH by WL and x2 is L by 2 plus TH by WL, right? So you have to remember these formulas or you have to derive those, right, while doing the problems. Right, you have to remember these things also. So the effect of wind and ice loading. So when there is a effect of wind and ice loading on the transmission line, then the total weight of the conductor will be WT is equal to under square root W plus WT whole square plus WW whole square. Here, so small w is the weight of the conductor per unit length and WT is the weight of the ice per unit length and WW is the wind force or wind pressure per unit length. So if you observe all W values, so this is the per unit length values. Okay, it may be per centimeter or per meter. Okay, so suppose if your W is W may be given directly, the weight per unit length. So in sometimes weight per unit length directly given. So in sometimes they may give the conductor material density and volume, right? So if they give the conductor material density and volume per unit length of the conductor, so then W will be calculated by using the second formula, which is W is equal to conductor material density into volume per unit length. Okay, so in a similar manner, weight of the ice per unit length, so this value also may not be given directly. Okay, so they may give the wind density of ice, so then volume of the ice per unit length, or they may give the diameter of the conductor and thickness of the ice coating. So depending upon what values they were given, you have to use either this formula or this formula. Okay, density of ice is given and volume is given, so then you have to multiply those two to get the WT, weight of the ice per unit, right? So if sometimes they may give the diameter of the conductor, small d, and thickness of this ice coating. In such a case, WT is equal to density of ice into pi by 4 into d plus 2t whole square minus d square into 1 you have to use. Okay, so this one here represents 1 meter length of the conductor. You are going to consider 1 meter length of the conductor. All right, so this from this formula you will get the second formula. Okay, density of ice into pi t d plus t. Okay, you have to expand this expression. Okay, so then you will get the second equation. So wind force or wind pressure per unit length of the conductor also not be given directly. Instead of, they will give the wind pressure per unit area and projector area per unit length, right? So if those two are given, then you have to multiply those two. Okay, so when diameter and thickness is given, so then wind pressure per unit length can be calculated as wind pressure multiplied by d plus 2t into 1. Okay, so these are the formulas you have to remember. Okay, all these formulas. And vertical sag, right? When there is no effect of wind and ice loading, there will be only weight of the conductor which acts downwards, vertically downwards, that W, weight of the conductor per unit length. So then the sag calculated is called the vertical sag. Suppose if you consider the wind pressure as well as ice coating also, so then your total weight will be in this direction. Okay, so here this is the WT. So now the sag calculated by using WT, it is called the vertical slant sag. Okay, slant sag, right? So then from slant sag you can determine the vertical sag by using the expression S into cos theta. So here S is the slant sag. Okay, so that's S value is WT L squared by 2T value. And suppose if you want to calculate theta, so by using this expression you can calculate the theta. Tan theta is equal to WW by W plus WT. So this you got from this diagram. Okay, so here you have to take the rectangular triangle, right? This value is theta. So tan theta is equal to WW by W plus WT you will get. So from this formula you can get the theta value, and from this formula you can get the slant sag value. So then vertical sag is equal to S into cos theta. Suppose in the problem if they were not mentioned vertical sag or anything, so then you have to always consider it as a slant sag only. Okay, if they were specifically mentioned vertical sag, then vertical sag you have to calculate, else you can calculate only slant sag only. Okay, right. Let us take the first problem. Okay, so a 132 kV transmission line has the following data. So here weight of the conductor is given, which is 680 kilograms per kilometer, and length of the span is given as 260 meters. Ultimate strength is 3100 kilograms, and safety factor is 2. So now you have to calculate the height of the height above the ground at which the conductor should be supported, and ground clearance is required is 10 meters. Okay, so here you have to calculate the height above ground at which the conductor should be supported. So that means if you are taking a transmission line tower and conductor, so this is your conductor, so these are the supporting points. Okay, so from where this, what is the height of this support from the ground, so this you have to calculate. Okay, not this value, and this value is given, clearance value is given as 10 meters, right? So what is so this is ground. So from the lowest point on the conductor and ground, this distance is called the clearance. So this is given as 10 meters. Okay, so this, now you have to calculate this distance. So the height of the conductor where it has been supported, so this value you have to calculate. Okay, and this height of the tower is equal height of the conductor above which it is supported is, it is equal to this sag. So this value, so this is sag, so sag plus 10 will be your answer. Okay, sag plus 10, so which is the clearance. Okay, sag plus 10 is equal to your answer, which is height above which the above the ground at which conductor should be supported. So you have to first calculate the sag from the given data. Okay, so now sag S is equal to W L square by 8T for level supports. Okay, so here they were not mentioned whether it is level supports or unlevel supports. So but if they were not mentioned, you consider them as a, so they are supported at equal levels. Okay, so when they are when the conductor is supported at equal levels, sag will be calculated by using the equation W L square by 8T. So what is W here? Weight of the conductor per unit length. Okay, so that unit length may be meter or centimeter. So now calculate the weight of the conductor per meter. Now so that W value is equal to, so here in the problem they were given as weight of the conductor is 680 kilograms per kilometer is given, right? So per kilometer is given, so you have to consider only for 1 meter. So then if you want to consider for 1 meter, you have to divide that 680 by 1000. So the weight of the conductor per meter run will be 0.68 kilograms you will get. Okay, so W value you got. So then what is L? Like in this formula, what is L? L is the span length. Okay, span length is also given in the problem itself, 260 meters. Okay, so no need to calculate that value. So then you have to consider calculate the tension. So if you observe the given problem, they were given the ultimate strength, and ultimate strength value is given and safety factor is given. Tension is not given. From this from these two you have to calculate the tension. Okay, so for calculating this tension, when the safety factor and ultimate strength is given, the formula is T is working tension or tension, T is equal to ultimate strength by safety factor. Okay, actually the safety factor formula is, so ultimate strength by working tension T. So from this formula, T working tension T is equal to ultimate strength by safety factor you will get. What is the, what do you mean by ultimate strength? So I was already said the opposite about this. What is ultimate strength? So generally your conductor will be given some sag, right? So to support for any weather condition, right? Instead of that, so if you stretch the conductor between these two ports fully, so that means your conductor is like a straight line. So then the tension on the conductor will be maximum, right? That maximum tension is also called as ultimate strength of the ultimate tension. Okay, so that value by safety factor will be the your working tension value. Okay, right. So working tension, from working tension T is equal to ultimate strength by safety factor. Here ultimate strength is 3100 kilograms and safety factor is 2. If you substitute those two, working tension you got is 1550 kilograms. Okay, now you got all the values in your sag equation, right? W value is 0.68 kilograms, L value is 260 meters, and T value is 1550 kilograms. So you substitute all the values, then you will get the sag as 3.7 meters. Then the conductor should be supported at a height of sag plus your clearance. So clearance is given as 10 meters. So sag value is 3.7. So 10 plus 3.7 is the 30.7 meters is your answer. Okay. Right now, is there any doubt here? Okay, you have to remember this equation. Working tension is equal to ultimate strength by safety factor. Okay. Right, next go to the second problem. So your transmission line has a span of 150 meters between level support. So span means that this L value is given. Okay, so L value you got. The conductor has a cross sectional area of 2 cm². Okay, cross sectional area of 2 cm², and the tension in the conductor is 200 kilograms. Okay, tension always will be measured in kilograms. Okay, so here tension also given, which is 200 kilograms. Okay, T value is given and L value is given. Okay, so then you have to calculate W. Now also here it is given that if the specific gravity of the conductor is 9.9 grams per centimeter cube and wind pressure is 1.5 kilograms per meter length, then calculate the sag. Okay, so what vertical sag also. Okay, after calculate sag in the sense slant sag you will get. Okay, after getting slant sag you have to calculate the vertical sag also. Okay, so length of the span is 150 meters, working tension is 200 kilograms. Now here W is given, not given. Okay, so W is the weight of the conductor per unit length. Instead of giving the W value, they were given the specific gravity of the conductor. Okay, that specific gravity of the conductor material is 9.9 grams per centimeter cube is given. Okay, so from this specific gravity you can calculate the weight of the conductor per unit length or per meter as by using this formula, which is specific gravity into volume of 1 meter conductor. Okay, so now a specific gravity here is 9.9 and volume of right? Now specific gravity is 9.9. Now volume of 1 meter conductor, right? Volume can be written as area into length. Okay, so now area is given here, which is 2 centimeters square. Okay, 9.9 into area is 2 into, so 1 meter length. Okay, so now if you observe this, area is given in centimeter square, and this value, specific gravity also in centimeter cubed. Okay, so now 1 meter means that 1 meter also length with this length value. So that 1 meter also you have to convert into centimeters. So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So this is the value. Specific gravity is 9.9, which is in grams per centimeter cube, and area is 2 centimeters square into length we were considered is 1 meter, which is 100. Okay, 1 meter is 100 centimeters. Okay, so now you see all the values. You are getting weight of the conductor per meter length as 1.98 kilograms. First you will get in grams, so then you convert into kilograms. Okay, now you got the W value. So that W value is the weight of the conductor which acts downwards, vertically downwards. Okay, here along with the weight of the conductor, so they were also specified the wind pressure. Wind pressure is 1.5 kilograms per meter length. Okay, so that WW, wind pressure, will act horizontally. Okay, so it will be represented horizontally, and weight of the conductor is W is vertically downwards. So this weight and this weight, sum of vector sum of these two is total weight of the conductor, which is WT. So that WT is equal to W square plus WW whole square. Okay, this is the total weight of the conductor for meter length. WT is equal to under square root W square plus WW whole square. Right, here you know the W value, which is 1.98 kilograms. So 1.98 into whole square plus WW value is given in the problem itself, which is 1.5 kilograms per meter. So this 1.5 whole square you have to take, right? So then total weight of the conductor what we are getting here is 2.48 kilograms. Okay, now you got all the values. Span length L is given, and torque is given, and total weight WT you were calculated. Okay, so now a sag, what, which is slant sag, can be calculated as S is equal to WT L square by 8T, or let's suppose 8T you will get, okay, in denominator. So now WT value is 2.48 kilograms, and L value is 150, and T value is 2000. We substitute all the values, then you will get the slant sag as 3.48 meters. Okay, so this slag, why you call it slant sag? So the weight, total weight of the conductor is in this direction, making at an angle theta with the vertical line. Okay, so now this sag, the sag calculated by using this weight, total weight, will be called as slant sag. So when we want to calculate the vertical sag, that value, vertical sag is equal to S into cos theta. Okay, so vertical sag is equal to S into cos theta. Now S value is slant sag, you were calculated already. And now you have to know the theta value. Okay, so theta value you can get from this equation. Tan theta is equal to WT by W, right? You take one this rectangle triangle, right? And this is, this value is theta, right? So then tan theta is equal to WT, opposite side, WT by adjacent side, which is W. So here they were taking this. Okay, WW by WT you will get. So that value is 0.76. Then theta value is 37.23 degrees. Okay, so now you substitute that theta value in vertical sag, you will get vertical sag. Okay, vertical sag value is 2.77 meters. Okay. Right. So let us go for the next problem. So problem number 3. So now here an overhead line has span length of 150 meters between the level supports. Okay, 150. Length of the span L is 150 centimeters, and the conductor has cross sectional area of 2 square centimeter. Ultimate strength is 500 kilogram per centimeter square, and safety factor is 5. Okay, the specific gravity of the material is 8.9 grams per cubic centimeter, and the wind pressure is 1.5 kilograms per meter. Calculate the height of the conductor above the ground level at which it should be supported if the minimum clearance is 7 meters. Right, here also you have to calculate the height of the conductor above the ground level at which it is supported. So that means if you take a transmission line conductor which is connected between two level supports, okay, so this clearance value is given, right? What sag, this value is a sag, okay, this is clearance. So then the conductor where it is supported at this point, so from here to ground, what is your height? This value you have to calculate. Okay, so this value is equal to sag plus clearance. Clearance value is 7 meters and given in the problem. So then you have to calculate the sag. After calculating the sag, if you sum sag plus this clearance, you will get the height of the conductor above the ground level at which it is supported. Okay, so right. So for in the given problem, length of the span is given as 150 meters. Okay, L value is given as 150 meters, and tension T is equal to T is not given directly. Instead of giving T, they were given the ultimate strength and safety factor. Okay, so from that value you have to calculate the working tension. Okay, so working tension T is equal to ultimate strength by safety factor. So 500 right, that value you are getting here is 2000 kilograms here. Okay, right. So then after getting this here, weight of the conductor, total weight of the conductor is, so to calculate the total weight of the conductor, you have to consider two, wind pressure as well as the weight of the conductor. So like in previous problem, you have to calculate first weight of the conductor per meter length, which is conductor area into 100 centimeters into specific gravity. Okay, so why this 100 centimeters we are taking? 1 meter length you have to consider. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. This conductor area and specific gravity both are given in centimeters here. If you observe in given problem, so this is given as 2 square centimeter, and specific gravity is 8.9 grams per cc and cubic centimeter cube. So as those two are given in centimeters, you have to take 1 meter as a 100 centimeter. Okay, so it is like in previous problem itself. Okay,
hello.
So then weight of the conductor W you are getting here is 1.78 kilograms.
Hello.
Chupma. Hello.
Sir, somebody has a problem to join the class.
Your voice is not clear, ma.
Sir, somebody has a problem.
Somebody has the problem to join
the class. It seems, sir. Problem and sir, kunta mandi class join avadaniki.
Class join avadanika. క్లాస్ జాయిన్ అవడానికమ్మా. హలో సో యాక్చువల్లీ ఐ థింక్ దే హ్యావ్ టు రిజిస్టర్ ఫస్ట్. ఆఫ్టర్ రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ దే విల్ గెట్ ద మెయిల్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ లింక్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు జాయిన్. Your voice is not clear. Uh, amma before when the class, so when the class is at 11 o'clock, so by 11 o'clock no, you have to join
sir, kani class join avvalekapothunnaranta
late ga join avutunnare ma vallu.
From 11 only they are trying, but it's not okay.
Those who are having the problem, they just send you a message.
They are net potunnaru sir, join avutu malli velipothunte malli join avutunte avvaledu
ante. Adi problem entante vaalla internet connection. Sometimes even me also getting the same problem na. Rendu moodu saarlu disconnect ayindi last time. Okay, so if there's those people internet connection is not good, so then they will be disconnected from the class. So that will be the internet connection problem. Okay, if the internet connection is good, they will get.
But so many members are getting this problem only, sir.
Okay,
two members, sir. So many members are not joined today.
Okay, you inform to those people to send me a WhatsApp message. So that I will inform to the sir.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, ma. Right here. So working tension value T is equal to, actually this is ultimate strength by safety factor. Okay, ultimate strength is 5000 is given, safety factor is 5 value is given, so you have to get a 1000 kilograms. Okay, so then why he is again multiplying with 2? Ultimate strength is 5000 kilograms per centimeter square. Right, ma. Here you take 5000 by 5 only. Okay, so 2 you should not take. This is 1000 kilograms. Okay, tension value. So then you have calculated the weight of the conductor per meter length, and you also know the wind pressure, which is 1.5 kilograms per meter. Right, now when you know the total weight of the conductor W and wind pressure W, so then total weight of the conductor per meter length is, so WT is equal to under square root W square plus WW square. Okay, W value is 1.78 and WW is 1.5. So if you substitute, total weight of the conductor will be 2.33 kilograms. Then slant sag is S is equal to WL square by 80T. So now here WT also know, L value is given in the problem, which is 150 meters span length, and T working tension T you are calculated from by using the ultimate strength and safety factor. Okay, all values you know, then you calculate the slant sag value, right? So slant sag value, after calculating the slant sag value, vertical sag is S into cos theta. Okay, so S into cos theta, right? Theta value you can calculate by using tan theta is equal to, so WT by WW. Okay, theta is equal to tan inverse of that. From that you will get the theta value. So that from that after getting the theta value, sag value you know in the previous equation. Right, then vertical sag is equal to S into cos theta value. Okay, here he is getting 2.5 meters, right? Then what is the total height above which the conductor is supported? That value is equal to this vertical sag into clearance. Okay, vertical sag is 2.5 and clearance is given in the problem itself. Okay, which is 7, right? 7 plus 2.5 is 9.5 meters is the height above which the conductor should be supported. Okay, so this third problem will be the mix of problem number 1 and problem number 2, ma. Okay, right, so next problem. So the heights of the towers of height is 30 cm and 90 cm respectively. So the towers of height 30 meters 90 meters respectively support a transmission line conductor at water crossing. Okay. So the horizontal distance between the towers is given as 500 meters. So if the tension in the conductor is 1600 kilogram, find the minimum clearance of the conductor and water and clearance midway between the supports. Okay. So weight of the conductor is given 1.5 kilograms per meter. So bases of the towers can be considered to be at water level. Okay. So from this, this is the problem when the supports are not at equal levels. Okay. Right. So here the two towers height is given, which is 30 meters and 90 meters respectively. Okay. So you see in the problem, you see in the diagram itself. So this height, so this is the water. This is the river crossing. Okay. So from the water level, that heights of the towers you have to consider. So top support A is at a height of 30 centimeter and support B is at a height of 90 meters. Okay. So 30 meters and 90 meters. So in the problem given. Okay. So two supports are at 30 meters and 90 meters. Okay. So this distance and distances you get. So then after knowing the tower heights, so then what is this H value? Okay. H value is equal to height of the total tower height B minus tower height A. So that means 90 minus A, you will get the value of H. Okay, 90 minus 30, right? 90 minus 30 is equal to 60 meters is the this height. Okay, so which is the difference between the two tower supports? Okay, H value. And in the given problem, weight of the conductor is W value is given, which is 1.5 kilograms, and tension is also given, which is 1600 kilograms, and the length of the span. Length of the span is given as 500 meters. Okay, L value is given, W value is given, T value is given, right? So, but here the supports are at unequal levels. So here you will get the two sags, S1 and S2. So here in this side, at support A, you will have the S1 and support B, you will be having S2. Okay, so what is this sag? Sag is the distance between minimum point on the conductor. So, right? So this O point is the minimum point on the conductor. So when the supports are not at equal levels, this minimum point is not at center of the conductor. Okay, when the conductors are at equal levels, then this minimum point will be at the center of the conductor. So, but when supports are not at equal levels, so this minimum point will not always be at the center of conductor. Okay. So it may be either, so now as tower height B is higher, so your minimum point will be towards the support A. Okay. So now let us assume here that X1 will be the distance from minimum point to support A, and X2 will be the distance from minimum point to support B. Okay. Then X1 plus X2 will be the total length, total span length. Okay. So L is equal to X1 plus X2 and L value is given as 500 meters. So X1 plus X2 will be equal to 500 meters you will get. Okay. So then after that, as you know the value of W and T and H also. So first you have to calculate the sag. Sag S1 is equal to W X1 square by 2T. Okay. And sag S2 is W X2 square by 2T. Okay, so these formulas you know. Okay, so now H value, if you consider this H value, H you can also say that S2 minus S1. Okay, this H value is S2 value minus S1 value, you will get H value, right? So now in S2, S2 minus S1 is a H value. So in place of S2 and S1, you are going to substitute these two equations. So WX2 square by 2T minus WX1 square by 2T. Okay, so in here you are having W by 2T as common. So when you take W by 2T as common, so then you will get W by 2T into X2 square minus X1 square. Okay, X2 square minus X1 square can be written as x2 plus x1 into x2 minus x1. Okay, so now you know the value of this x1 plus x2 as 500 meters. Okay, x1 plus x2 as 500 meters. So then you substitute that value here. Okay, so then you will get the x2 minus x1. Okay, h value also you know here, which is 60 meters. H value you know, which is 60 meters, and W value you know, which is 1.5 kilogram, and T value you know, which is 1600 kilogram. If you want x2 plus x1 value is you know, which is 500 meters. So now if you substitute all those values, you will get the x2 minus x1 value. Okay, so x2 minus x1 is equal to, if you substitute all those values, you will get the 256 meters. Okay, so this is the x2 minus x1. And x2 minus x2 plus x1 value is 500 meters. Now if you solve this equation and this equation, so by solving those two equations, you will get the x1 and x2 values. So that x2 value and x1 values are, x1 is equal to 122 meters and x2 is equal to 378 meters. Okay, you are getting this x1 and x2. After getting s1 and s2, you can calculate sag s1 and sag s2. Okay, s1 is equal to w x1 square by 2t, s2 is equal to w by W x2 square by 2t, right? So in these two formulas, you know all the values, W value, T value, X1 value, X2 value, okay? So you will get S1 and S2 values. So when you substitute all the values in those formulas, you will get S1 and S2. Okay, see here. So S1 you are getting 7 meters. Right, so now s2 value also you can get, okay, when you take the s2 is equal to wx2 square by 2t, but here we were not required to calculate the s2 value, so that s2 value is not necessary in this problem. So s1 only we are calculating, which is 7 meters. Okay, so now go back to the problem here. So s1 is the height from minimum point to support A. Okay, so minimum point to support A, which is S1 value. This S1 value is 7 meters. You got, right? So now what is clearance? This is the clearance. Clearance is the distance from ground level or water level to your center of the conductor. Okay, so from center of the conductor point O to this ground, this is the clearance. Okay, so that clearance can be taken as, so now you know the total height of the tower A will be 30. Okay, and you know this sag, so this value, sag value is distance from these two, support A and minimum point level. So then you will get this value now. So this clearance value is equal to 30 minus your sag, which is 7. So 30 minus 7, this is clearance at the minimum point. Okay, that is what you are getting here. Okay, so clearance of lowest point O from water level, or water level, instead of water level, they make you sometimes ground level. Okay, so that value is 30 minus 7, which is 23 meters. Okay, so this is the clearance which is between water level and your center of the conductor. S1 value is 7, but according to which? Okay. Amma, you can also calculate the S2 value also. Okay, so now your main, if you see the problem, you have to calculate the minimum clearance. Find the minimum clearance, okay? Minimum clearance, but it is the distance from water level or ground to minimum point on the conductor, right? Minimum point is O, and your ground level is this one, right? So you, here you have to calculate this distance and O to your ground, Okay, so when you can calculate S1 or S2, from S1 or S2 you can get the this clearance value. Okay, so if you take, if you calculate the S1 value, you have to consider this tower height. Okay, this total height. So total height, this height is given as so about A is at 30 meters in the water level. Okay, so total height from water level to A up to this point, this value is 30. Okay, and you also calculate the sag S1. So S1 is the, so this distance to A to minimum point. So this distance is the S value. So minimum clearance is this distance, which is equal to this 30 minus S1. 30 minus S1 is 7. So then you are getting 20. Okay. So now if you calculate S2 also, you can get the same value. Suppose if you are calculate there this S2 value, right? So then, so from this tower you can calculate the clearance. This total is 90 meters. So total height is meters. Okay, and S2 value is, which is from minimum point to your tower B. S2 value you are getting. So then this clearance will be minus S2. Okay, you calculate both S1 and S2, right? From any one value you can calculate the clearance. Is it clear now? S1 minus S2 value, S2 minus S1 value is H4, right? So, but they were not asked about this height value, ma. So they were not asked the H value. They asked the clearance. I'm unable to get your doubt. Once you unmute and speak. Okay, right. If you under, if you understood, it is okay. Okay. Right, ma. If you are having any doubt, again also you can WhatsApp me. Right. So this is the clearance which is from lowest point on the conductor. Okay. So if you are having unlevel supports, right? Unlevel supports means minimum point is not midpoint of the conductor. Okay. So now here they were asked to find out the minimum clearance as well as clearance at midpoint also. Okay. Clearance at midway between the towers also they were asked, along with the minimum clearance of the conductor and water. So they were also asked to find out the clearance which is midway between supports. So that means you have to consider a point P which is midway between the conductor. Okay, that means from the total distance is between the supports is length of the span, which is 500 meters. Okay, so now midway means at 250 meters you have to consider the point P. Okay, so point P is exactly at 250 meters from A as well as from B also. Okay, at this point which is at midway between the conductor, you have to calculate the clearance again. So that means this value you have to calculate from P to ground or water level. This value, what is this is called the clearance at midway between the supports. Now how you can calculate this value? Now let us see how you can calculate. How you can calculate, ma'am? So now here you have to first calculate the sag at this point. So right, so sag at this point is nothing but, so from this point to minimum point, this is the sag at point P. Okay, sag is nothing but it is the distance from minimum point to a point where you are considered. Suppose if you want to calculate the sag at this support B, so this is S2 value. Okay, if you want to calculate the sag at S, point A, support A, this will be S1 value. So now I want to calculate the sag, which is at the point. That means at this point you have to consider. Okay, so now to calculate sag at this point, so the general formula is S is equal to so W X square by 2T. Right, general formula actually it is Y is equal to W X square by 2T. Okay, now here what is this Y? This vertical distance, and X here is this horizontal distance, which is from O to P. Okay, okay, right, this Y you can call it as sag at point P. Okay, sag at point P is equal to W X square by 2T. So that means you will get this height. Okay, from O to P, this height will be the sag at point P. Okay, so which is equal to W X square by 2T. That value you are going to calculate. Okay, see in the next slide. So you are going to calculate the sag at midpoint P. So that is said here as S mid, sag at midpoint, which value is equal to W X square by 2T. Okay, W X square by 2T. Now what is X here? X is the distance from point P to your minimum point on the conductor. This distance, point P to O, this point P to O is the X distance. How you will get this X distance value? Right? So your point P is exactly at 250 meters from support A as well as support B also. So that means point P is at midpoint. So from B or A, it will be 250 meters. Okay? Now here, if you observe, this total distance, this is 250 meters. Now, what is this? So 250 meters, this 250 meters is, this 250 meters, it can be written as this X1 plus X, isn't it? So this is, this distance is 250 meters, right? This 250 meter value is equal to this X1 plus X. So X value is equal to 250 minus X1. Then what is X1 value? This is 122 meters. Okay. So X is equal to 250 minus 122. So you will get X value. Okay. So that X value here is 250 minus X1. So which is 250 minus 122, which is 128 meters. Right. After calculating the X value, sag at midpoint is W X square by 2T. So here W and T values are directly given in the problem, and X1 X value is 128 meters. So then if you substitute all the values, sag at midpoint is 7.68 meters. Okay. So now the clearance from midpoint P to water level. So from the given diagram, you see here. So here from midpoint to water, so this mid clearance, midway between this clearance is ever asked. Now this value is equal to this height plus this sag at point P, which is S mid. Okay, so this value how much here? This value will be 30 minus minimum clearance, which is 28. Sorry, 30 minus that 7 value, 23 I think. Okay, so that value plus this S mid value, so that will be the clearance at midway between the towers. Okay, so 23 plus 7.38. okay, this 23 mark, so this will be the, this 23 is the clearance at midpoint, whether you are understood or not. Okay, so this 23 meters, this clearance is the distance from here to here. So that means this distance. So this distance is 23 meters. Okay. So that means this distance you will get 23. Now here to here, this is S mid value. So sum of S mid plus this 23 will be the clearance between point P to water level, which is called midway clearance. Okay. So that midway clearance, what you are getting here is 30.68 meters. Okay. So go to the next problem, which is similar to the previous problem itself. Okay. So here an overhead transmission line at a river crossing is supported from two towers of height 40 meters or 90 meters above the water level. So the horizontal distance is 400 meters, and if the maximum allowable tension is 2000 kilograms, find the clearance between the conductor and water at a point midway between the towers. Okay, weight of the conductor is directly given as 1 kilogram per meter. Okay, so it is a similar to the previous problem one. So two towers or heights are given, 40 meters and 90 meters. So then distance between the towers, which is length of the span, is given as 400 meters. Okay, so in the given problem right. So one small difference is there in this problem, I will explain. And maximum allowable tension is 200 kilograms. Tension is also given. So here you have to calculate the clearance between the conductor and water at midpoint. That means S mid you have to calculate. Okay, clearance at midpoint. Okay, so you have to consider a midpoint P. Right. So from this side you have to calculate, like in previous case. Okay. So but what is the difference in this problem and the previous problem is that you see once you solve if you get. So here H value is this total tower height minus this total tower height. That means 90 minus 40 will get 50. Okay, length of the span is given 400 meters and tension is given as 200 kilograms and weight of the conductor is also directly given, which is 1 kilograms per meter. Okay, so now x1 plus x2. Right, here you have to consider one minimum point O. So which is not at midpoint. Okay, so you have to consider a minimum point O on the conductor. Okay, generally when the supports are not at equal levels, this minimum point will not be at the center of the tower, center of the conductor. Okay, so let us consider this will be the minimum point O. So now this minimum point is x1 distance from point A and x2 distance from point B. Okay, so now x1 plus x2 will be the total length of the span, which is 400 meters in the from 400 meters. So x1 plus x2 is equal to 400 meters. Here I am not mentioned 400, there it is wrong, 500, not 500, it is 400. Okay, so now this H value you can also calculate by using sag s2 minus s1. Okay, so s2 value is wx2 square by 2t minus wx1 square by 2t, right? In the similar to the previous case, H value what is 50 meters, w by 2t. If you take here in this problem, w by 2t common. So then x2 square minus x1 square you will get. x2 square minus x1 square again can be written as x2 plus x1 into x2 minus x1. So now again in this problem, x2 minus x2 plus x1 value is 400 meters. So from this you can calculate the x2 minus x1 value, right? So x2 minus x1 value what you are getting is 500 meters. Okay, so now this is x2 minus x1 and this is x1. If you solve those two equations, you will get the x1 and x2. Yes, now here x2 you are getting is 450 meters and x1 is here is minus 50 meters. So you see here x1 is minus you are getting here. So in the previous case, both two, x1 and x2, both two are up in plus values only. Okay, so but here you are getting minus. Okay, so x1 is minus 50 meters. So that means what is x1 here actually? X1 is the distance from minimum point to your support A. Okay, so this distance is the x1 value. So it is in solution you are getting this value is minus 50. And x2 value, what is the x2 value? X2 value is distance from this minimum point to this support B. So this distance, so you are getting 450 meters. So that means generally this total, this length of this span from A to B, this total is 400 only. So now he, but x2 value is 450 meters. So from this, these two values, what you can say, right? What you can say, your midpoint O is not at, not in the, not between A and B, it is outside A. So at a distance 451 B. So that means at this point you are having point O. Okay, so that means your conductor will be like this. So here you are getting, okay, so this distance is 400, so the from O to this is 50. So from B to O, which is x2 value is 450 meters and x1 value is minus 50. Okay, so you see in the next next diagram you can clearly understand here. So here observe this figure. Observe this figure. Right. So your point O is left side to your A point, support A. Okay. So from B to this O distance is 450 meters, and A to O is, this is negative side, that means left side. So it is 50 meters only, but in negative side. Okay, negative side from K. Okay, right. Now horizontal distance of midpoint P from lowest point. So what is the horizontal distance from of point P from O? So this value is can be X. Let us assume it to be X. So let us consider first your point, midpoint P, right? So this is P is at midpoint of the conductor. Now from P to this O distance is X. You have to consider, okay? So that distance X can be data explained, X can be calculated as X is equal to distance from A to O, A to O, this value 50 meters, and total distance by 2. Okay, so actually you are having two towers, ma. So which are the distance between two towers is 400 meters, right? So now in midpoint, in midway between these two, you have to consider point P. So that means, so this distance is 200 meters. Okay, from P to A is 200 meters. So then P to O will be this 200 plus 50. Okay, 250 will be the distance from point to P to O. Right, now S mid value. So S mid value, point to P to O distance. This distance is the S mid value. Okay, so that value is equal to WX squared by 2T, and WT value is given in the problem. X value is 250 meters. If you substitute, so you will get the midpoint sag, which is 15.6 meters. Now you are getting this distance. What is this distance? Right. So if you get this distance, so then total distance you will get. Okay. So what is that distance here? So now here, first you calculate sag 2. Sag 2, when you calculate, so this sag S2 is equal to WX2 square by 2T. Now this X2 here you have to consider is 450 meters. Okay. So from B to O it is 450 meters. So you will get 50.6 meters, right? So this distance you are getting as 50.6 meters, and you know the total height. So which is 90 meters, I think. So 90 minus 50.6 will be the this height. Okay. Okay. Right. You are getting sag 2. After getting sag 2, B is 90 meters. 90 minus S2 will be the this distance. Okay. And this distance plus S mid will be the clearance at midpoint. Okay, so that clearance at midpoint is what you are getting here is 55 meters. This is how you can solve this problem. Right, ma? So you have another problem here. So once you go through this problem, here gradient is given.